Hey YouTube, it's Expression2 here, and this is my first video that I'm going to upload to YouTube, and it's a tutorial on Expression2 in Gary's Mod. And this is for the people that don't really know much about it. This is episode 1, and I made this because, well, when I was not that experienced with E2, I had to sort of look up videos myself, and I couldn't really find that many. There were some that helped a little, but I decided that I should make one myself so I could help other people, so might as well get started. Also, this is glitching up a little from my recorder, and I was hoping people could sort of comment to see if I could have a better one, because this one seems to be ruining the game, sort of. I can't see as much, and it doesn't record some of the stuff that should come up on the screen. What am I using? Camestia or something. Camestia, I think. Anyway, might as well start. This is the name of your E2. That's what that stands for, obviously. So, I'm going to name it because it's my first tutorial. Tutorial, and the topic is pretty much just the basic parts of E2. I'm not going to go through parts of the code, but I'm going to explain these parts. I'll start off with the code probably in the next tutorial. First tutorial, basics. Now, when you click save or save as, it'll come up with this, and click OK, it'll save all in here. By the way, this is Garage Mod 13, sorry. And click OK, and it should spawn it, and because my display recorder doesn't really handle this, I can't really see it, neither can you, but you should be able to look at this, and it'll come up as like sort of a speech bubble that says the name of your E2. And when you look in here somewhere, I probably should update that first. It should come up first tutorial, if you put it that first. Here it is. Basics. That's what you've done. I'm gonna hide that for a second. Now for inputs. Inputs and outputs, really. They both do a lot of the same thing. If you, let's put in the first input, I guess. Input. Now this is a variable. It's a numeric variable, which is a number. And output is the same thing. If you want to change it to string, you've got to put the colon and string. Should turn orange if you did it right, but we're not going to learn about that for right now. Okay, input, output. Now, if you upload that, or just spawn it, really, spawn it, and now you scroll down to Wire Advanced, because Wire Legacy, you know, it's a bit boring. I don't like it that much. Because it won't come up for me, I can't really show you that easily, so. Which is why I really wanted some comments. If you could send me some, please. What you do is just move your cursor over this, and should have probably outputs, I think. Now if you click output with your left click mouse, I'm going to do it for me. And then you've got, you're wiring the output, and then you, if you did it correctly, you look back at E2 and it'll have input. So you're wiring output to input, so you're wiring the E2 to itself. Now, we'll go over persist. This is basically neither an output or an input, and it's stuff that's pretty much just goes inside this part of the code here. Now, I will put A for one of the variables. Because now that we've done that, if you go back down to the wire tool, it won't be in input or output if you click it. So it just does stuff inside the E2. A trigger, you can have trigger all. I'm not really sure what it completely does, but yeah, I usually just delete it because I never really use it. I probably won't be able to explain it in a tutorial, so yeah, sorry about that. But I don't think it's really that important to have. Anyway, that's the first tutorial, so see you guys, please like and subscribe.